isn't the ref counting? Kick to the jaw. Here comes the Undertaker. Drop in the leg across the chest. That is why the legendary Undertaker's in control.
Legendary. The man is the cornerstone of the WWE.
And the reason the referee is not counting JBL is because the action is continuing. Before, when we saw the Undertaker outside the ring.
Triangle choke! Triangle choke!
And this could not.
I have been in this with the Undertaker. I've almost lost the championship to Undertaker in this very move.
But again, this will force the great Khali. This could pass him out. This could knock him out, allowing the Undertaker to pick up the victory.
Could pass him out. You put your arm over your head, you can't breathe. You can't, blood quits going to your brain.
And now the Undertaker asking referee Nick Patrick to begin the count. And the referee does.
This could be it.
And a count of two, the great Khali, not quite sure where he is.
Blood rushes back to your head, Michael. I've been there. You get this terrible headache. You wake up like you're in a different room than you were when you last were conscious.
A count of six. The great Khali has four ticks left to try to make it to his feet, and he does, but the great Khali is wobbling. And again, he falls down. The giant is out. Look at this. Khali with a steel chair. Legal. No disqualifications, but perhaps not a small move.
But it didn't faze the Undertaker.
The Undertaker on the attack, stalking the great Khali's manager, his handler, and Daivari in trouble. Daivari.
This is bad.
The Undertaker has no heart. Here comes Khali, the great Khali, making his way up the ramp. And there's a low blow by Daivari.
But anything's legal, Michael.
Great Khali, clubby blow to the back of the neck, and then a headbutt. Both men in a dangerous predicament. Undertaker trying to battle his way out. Oh my, great Khali with a hand around the throat.
A little taste of his own medicine.
Undertaker's in trouble.
Wow.
But he's got Khali. Here's Daivari, boot to the head. Khali from behind, bouncing the Undertaker off the structure. Again, stalling steel.
I've never seen somebody manhandle the Undertaker.
Oh my God!
I believe Khali has done it again.
Referee Nick Patrick at a count of five.
Undertaker's
there.
Undertaker's not moving. This is it, Michael. This is it. I can't believe Khali is beating the Undertaker.
A count of eight for referee Nick Patrick. The Undertaker trying to make it to his feet. Did he? And he did. The Undertaker back in the game. This is not over. Can the Undertaker win this? Can he be the last man standing when we return? We are back on SmackDown. A brutal, a vicious last man standing match. Great Khali in control after tossing the Undertaker off the platform and through utility tables. And JBL, the Undertaker barely made the 10 count before the break.
I've never seen the Undertaker have to reach down that deep within his own soul, if he has one, to get up. I've never seen the Undertaker manhandle like Khali is doing to him now.
SmackDown fans trying to get the dead man back in the matchup. But at this point, it may be to no avail. The great Khali, much as he's done the past few months, has dominated the Phenom.
What we are wrestling for, what we are fighting for right now, Michael, is who is the biggest monster on SmackDown. And we will find out tonight between these two giants.
For 15 years, The Undertaker's been the big dog in his yard, the ring. The great Khali looking to lay claim to the yard here tonight.
I first wrestled The Undertaker 11 years ago on Monday Night Raw, and I've never seen him like this.
And you've been in battles with The Undertaker, including Last Man Standing, including many brutal matches over your career.
My head will look like a baseball if I ever go bald. I've had so many stitches from The Undertaker. I've been to hell and back with The Undertaker. And I could never beat him like Khali is doing right now.
Khali, as I said earlier, has almost made The Undertaker seem mortal. But The Undertaker almost calling for more abuse, more punishment, as the great Khali delivers a headbutt. Oh, this is not good. This is not good, ladies and gentlemen. Undertaker is wrapped up in the ropes, and now The Undertaker completely defenseless against his 7'3", 420-pounder. And that is the chop that has leveled The Undertaker in the past.
This is going to get ugly, Michael. This is going to get ugly.
Two chops. Undertaker nearly locks us now in the ropes.
Oh, this is not good. This is brutal. Absolutely brutal.
And a kick to the face.
What you're seeing is the destruction of the Phenom. this could be the end of The Undertaker. And Undertaker is down, flat on his back. Referee Nick Patrick at a count of two. Great Khali strutting around the ring like this is over.
It's almost sad, Michael, to watch the career, the great legacy of The Undertaker end like this. The Phenom is finished. Wow. Didn't think I'd see this.
At a count of eight, referee Nick Patrick.
Wow.
Count of nine. Oh, my. The Undertaker's down. The Undertaker's down. At a count of nine. Great Khali with almost a look of disbelief on his face. Right hands by the Phenom. And the Hall of Famer trying to get back in this match. And these monsters exchanging blows center of the ring.
That's like getting hit with a brick bat, Michael. I've been there on the receiving end of The Undertaker.
There's the striker. The Undertaker. Clothesline. Khali not going to cover him. But he's still landing on his feet. Somehow, now down to one knee.
We are watching World War III, Michael. Only on SmackDown will you see two giants go at it like this.
Again, this is last man standing. Great Khali, reversal. Undertaker, knees first to the steps.
Oh, my God.
No disqualifications, no countouts. The only way to win, keep your opponent down so he cannot answer the count of 10. And Daivari directing traffic. The Great Khali with those steel steps. Oh, my. Oh, my. Khali tossing the steps to the ring.
Thomas is late.
Listen to this. Knees met steel, and that will ground a big man.
That'll ground a Boeing 747, Michael.
Undertaker crawling across the ring. Great Khali back in the ring. Undertaker steel steps off the skull.
Wow.
I'm not sure either one's going to survive.
Undertaker. Daivari. Bringing the chair into the ring. Undertaker with the right hand.
That's a weapon he doesn't need.
Khali stinging from the steps to the head. But this weapon is perfectly legal.
Oh, my God.
And Khali has been busted open.
This is like teeing one up for Barry Burns.
Oh, again, the steel chair. Great Khali down to the mat, blood pouring from his skull.
The chair hammering the forehead of Khali right down into steel. It's like teeing one up for Barry Bonds. The last thing The Undertaker needs is a weapon. I'm not sure either man is going to make it.
Referee Nick Patrick at a count of six. Great Khali's got to get back to his feet before 10. There's a count of seven. Great Khali a bloody mess back to his feet at eight.
These two gentlemen are destroying each other.
But can you feel it? Can you feel like the momentum has suddenly shifted? The Undertaker with right hands.
First time, Michael Cole, I've ever even heard of somebody busting open Khali.
Oh, a steel chair! Wow. Literally wrapped around Khali's skull.
Steel on cranium.
You've got to get a chair.
Look at the chair.
Look at the chair. Look at the bend in the chair. That is the shape of Khali's skull.
I've never seen Khali like this.
Undertaker.
You've got to be kidding
Khali.
Me.
Khali, chokeslam, chokeslam, chokeslam. Undertaker. Back to the neutral corner. Count of three for the referee. Listen to the SmackDown fans.